Lara Croft is back. Since 1996, she's traveled all around the world putting her lovely assets in grave danger for your amusement. For this outing, you'll get to play co-op with a friend in this first ever digital download Lara Croft experience. We shot over to Crystal Dynamics to chat with Carl Stewart and Daniel Neuberger to find out more about what makes this Lara Croft adventure so different than any other. And don't worry, even though she may be a little smaller this time, she's still got her guns.
Why do you consider Lara Croft to be such an enduring character over the years?
Wow, I think it's because most all gamers will remember that from PlayStation 1 and even early PC, it was one of those very first games to do 3D and really bring unique and different experience that it wasn't so much about the story, it was about the experience that it brought, being able to get into these tombs and sort of spend some time thinking about puzzles. So I think over the years, as the franchise has expanded, people have remembered that that was one of the very first games they ever played. So she's endearing and she's become iconic just because she's one of the very few that's been around for so long.
One of the things we really strive to do is keep the core of what makes a Lara Croft game a Lara Croft game still there. So we still have the fun action puzzles, we still have combat, and we have lots of great exploration and really stunning environments.
Lara is no stranger to danger, so what new challenges are the developers going to put in Lara's way? I mean, geez, can't a girl ever just walk down a path without needing to jump for her life?
Instead of getting into these real deep stories, we've created this kind of very light story about Lara. You can imagine for the last sort of 14 years, she's been traveling around the world, getting these sort of epic journeys. Now she's getting a chance to go back and kind of do all those secondary, smaller expeditions that she wished she had gone on.
Lara's in the Central American jungle. She's searching for an ancient artifact known as the Mirror of Smoke.
And the story is that Totec was the guardian of light for the Mirror of Smoke. And in this Mirror of Smoke, they basically held down this evil lord called Zolot.
There's a little bit of trouble and it falls into the wrong hands, and now she's on an adventure to get it back to safety before the end of the world. We really tried on this game to make it an even split between puzzles, combat, and exploration, which are the three main pillars of a Tomb Raider experience, and then we've infused each of those with a co-op experience.
We've kind of retracted the camera back compared to the third-person style that you've traditionally played in Lara. And as well as that, it's co-op. It gives the players opportunity to see two people on the screen and play with your friends.
So the two players actually have different tools they can use mostly to help the other player. So the two players really have to depend on each other to get through all the challenges we throw at them. Lara has her trademark grapple hook, which she can throw to Totec at any time, and they can use that to climb up and down walls and swing back and forth anywhere in the game. Totec is the master of the shield and spear, so he can obviously use those for combat, but he has even cooler uses for those in the co-op play. He can use the shield to boost Lara up to high places, he can also use the spear to throw it in the wall, and Lara can jump to them and cross really big chasms.
We give them objectives that they have to sort of traverse environments, work together, think about situations, and it really brings a sort of totally different gameplay to anything we've done before, so players have to sit and talk to each other, think about how to get over an objective.
When you're playing single player, we've actually added abilities to Lara so she can actually get through the adventure on her own. Totec is still part of the story and he'll pop in every once in a while, but you play through just as Lara. One of my big goals for this is to make it truly a co-op experience, something that two players are going to create a connection, the same connection the two players on screen are creating.
We like that Lara now has some company on her adventures, but for us hardcore Tomb Raider fans, it's still all about Lara.
Even now, if you look at video games, Lara still is one of the strongest female characters in video games. I mean, she kind of has the whole package. She's action-oriented, she's really smart, and I think that if you look at the rest of the video game industry, there aren't a lot of strong female characters.
I found a little quote from the message boards that I wanted to run by you. They said, "This seems to be an epic pile of not seeing enough booby." Your response?
Well, I think that in our game, we have that isometric camera, which kind of gives you a greater sense of Lara's whole body and maybe doesn't focus on any one of her assets. Really, the experience for this game is to focus on the gameplay and focus on Lara, her interactions with the puzzles and traps, inside the environments that Tomb Raider fans love. That's really been one of our main focuses, is really creating a game that's for the fans of the series that lives in between our major pillar releases.
You hear that, boys? Eyes on the game.